He rocks in a tree top all the day long. Hopping in a thank you.
thank you so very much. My name is Lauren, and we appreciate you guys coming out for this 4th of July patriotic concert in the park. This is our 6th year doing this, and it always blows me away when I turn around after I start and I see so many of you here, and thank you so much. It's interesting, as we start the afternoon, people come, and the seats start in the back, and as the shade comes this way, people come this way. And so now that the shade's coming, I expect you guys can come out even a little closer. We are going to do something right now that's become also a tradition. We are going to sing a rendition, a medley of the armed services salutes, each of the armed services. And so when you hear your service, we would like to have the service members, either that you have served or that you have relatives that have served, stand and sing that section. Will you do that for me? Okay, excellent. Here we go.
Three, four, five.
if you served in the armed forces, stay, all stand together and let's give you a round of applause again. Please, if you were part of the... We thank you for your service and your dedication and your sacrifice. Well, I would like to introduce our United States Congressman, Tom McClintock. This is his, I think, fourth year of coming and welcoming us and bringing in the holiday with us. So, Tom, if you'd come over, let's welcome Congressman Tom McClintock.
Well, thank you, folks. Tonight I'd like to share with you the words that John Adams spoke when the Continental Congress took up consideration of the Declaration of Independence. It's remarkable when you think back upon how bleak those times were. Just a few weeks before the debate began on the Declaration, King George had issued a proclamation warning them that if they proceeded any farther, they would be declared traitors, they'd be hunted down by the most powerful army on the planet and hanged. Just a few days before this debate began, they received word that Lewis Morris, the delegate from New York, his estate had been burned to the ground. His family were now refugees. His two oldest sons were now enlisted in the ragtag army gathering around General Washington. That's what was going on when they took up this declaration. And this is what John Adams said when the debate began. He said, "Sink or swim, live or die, survive or perish. I give my hand and my heart to this vote. It is true indeed that in the beginning we aimed not at independence, but there is a divinity which shapes our ends. The injustice of England has driven us to arms and blinded to her own interest for our good. She has obstinately persisted till independence is now within our grasp. If we fail, it can be no worse for us, but we shall not fail. The cause will raise up armies. The cause will create navies. The people, if we are true to them, will carry themselves gloriously through this struggle. I care not how fickle other people have been found. I know the people of these colonies, and I know that resistance to British aggression is deep and settled in their hearts and cannot be eradicated. Every colony, indeed, has expressed its willingness to follow if we will but take the lead. Sir, the Declaration will inspire the people with increased courage. Read this Declaration at the head of the army. Every sword will be drawn from its scabbard and the solemn vow uttered to maintain it or to perish on the bed of honor. Publish it from the pulpit. Religion will approve it. And the love of religious liberty will cling round it, resolved to stand with it or to fall with it. Send it to the public halls. Proclaim it there. Let them hear it, who heard the first roar of the enemy's cannon. Let them see it, who saw their brothers and their sons fall on the field of Bunker Hill or in the streets of Lexington and Concord, and the very walls will cry out in its support. Sir, I know the uncertainty of human affairs, but I see clearly through this day's business. You and I indeed may rue it. We may not live to the time when this declaration shall be made good. We may die colonists, die slaves, die, it may be, ignominiously and on the scaffold. Be it so. If it be the pleasure of heaven that my country shall require the poor offering of my life, the victim shall be ready at the appointed hour of sacrifice, come when that hour may. But while I do live, let me have a country, or at least the hope of a country, and that a free country. But whatever may be our fate, be assured that this declaration will stand. It may cost treasure and it may cost blood, but it will stand and it will richly compensate for both. Through the thick gloom of the present, I see the brightness of the future as the sun in heaven. We shall make this a glorious day, an immortal day. When we are in our graves, our children will honor it. They will celebrate it with thanksgiving, with festivity, with bonfires and illuminations. On its annual return, they will shed tears, copious, gushing tears, not of subjugation and slavery, not of agony and distress, but of exultation, of gratitude, and of joy. Sir, before God, I believe the hour has come. My judgment approves this measure, and my whole heart is in it. All that I have, and all that I am, and all that I hope in this life, I am now ready here to stake upon it. And I leave off as I began, that live or die, survive or perish, I am for the Declaration. It is my living sentiment, and by the blessing of Almighty God, it shall be my dying sentiment, independence now and independence forever. And thus it began, and here we are today, 239 years later, with the solemn realization that everything that they fought for, everything that they accomplished, is now in the hands of each of us and of our generation. So happy birthday, America.
Thank you. Yeah.
those that recognize, that's the Gershwin favorite wonderful Americana piece, Rhapsody in Blue, done in a great big band style. I'm going to bring out a small group right now made up of a conglomeration of folks from Placer Pops and from Auburn Grace Church, and we're going to do an orchestral and a small group version of the other Gershwin, another Gershwin classic from his great work, Porgy and Bess, called Summertime, and today is Summertime. We're just going to change out a few people. I'm going to bring up a group that we did this in our spring concert with the Placer Pops, and it's a great medley of songs. You'll recognize most of them from Jersey Boys.
Oh, 23. What a very special time for me. I remember what a night. Oh, I
had a funny feeling when she walked in that room.
Yeah,
as I recall, it ended much too soon.
Oh, what a night. Hypnotizing, mesmerizing me. She was everything in dreams she'd be. Sweet surrender, what a night. Oh, what a night. Working my way back to you, babe, with a burning love inside. Yes, I'm working my way back.
Cake and eat it too, but how I cried over losing you.
See, I'm counting out, and I hope that darling's been tearing without urging you.
Every day I made you cry. I'm saying, girl, till the day that I die.
Just one more.
One more time.
Oh, won't you
say
just a little bit longer.
Say,
please, 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 please tell me you're gonna
stay.
There ain't no good in our goodbye.
Hang on.
take my eyes off of you. You'd be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. At long last, love has arrived, and I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you.
Tall oak tree. The wise old owl, the big black crow, flapping their wings, sing, go bird, go, rockin' robin, tweet, 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 rockin' robin, tweet, 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 go, rockin' robin, cause we're really gonna rock it tonight. Tweet, tweet, heard a little raven at the bird stand, top the robin, the bobbin, it was grand. His daughter goes today, bless my soul. He hopped about the buzzing and the hop view. He rocked in the treetop, hopped it along, hopping and a Bob and Doug singing their song. All the other birdies on J-Bot Street that love to hear the robber go tweet, tweet.
Rock and Robin, tweet, tweet, tweet. Tweet, Rock and Robin, tweet, tweet.
Oh, Rock and Robin, close the